Today we're in southern Ouachita Parish and it's July 15th, hot, humid, a perfect day to be in the watermelon patch. And the watermelons you see behind me are a variety that was developed right here in Ouachita Parish at the LSU AgCenter's North Louisiana Experiment Station, also called the Calhoun Research Station. It closed about 10 years ago. The watermelon that we're going to look at today was developed and released back in 1987. It's called the Red and Sweet. Well, back in February of this year, I was giving a talk to the Marion Garden Club up in Union Parish and was approached by someone who said they had some seeds that they thought were of a watermelon variety developed at the Calhoun Research Station. And watermelon and Calhoun grabbed my attention because everyone is still interested in a watermelon called the Calhoun Sweet, which we have managed to find. But what the seeds actually were of a variety called Red and Sweet. This is the last watermelon variety that was developed and released from the North Louisiana Experiment Station, or the Calhoun Research Station. It was released in 1987. It's a striped melon with kind of a peculiar indentation on the blossom end, which is, you don't see that in modern varieties. This melon and several other varieties that were developed and released from the Calhoun Station are bred for local markets. They have a very thin rind compared to varieties that are developed for shipping. So not a good long distance traveler, but a wonderful watermelon for local markets. The name is Red and Sweet, and it is just that. The flesh of this watermelon is dark vermilion red, almost like red velvet cake. And the sugar levels are just not to be believed. I've harvested two. This is one vine, by the way. I've harvested two melons so far off this single vine. Both melons have come in with brick scores of 12 and 13, respectively. So very high sugar content. Not only were watermelons developed and bred at the Calhoun Station, but peaches, field peas, and several other varieties of vegetables. It was also a dairy. It also had poultry flocks. They had an orchard. And believe it or not, a lot of people still remember some of the varieties released from the Calhoun Station and still ask for them. And we're going to do our best to make sure when we locate an old variety from the Calhoun Station, we save the seeds and get them back out into circulation so folks can still enjoy those varieties.